Okay, let's see how we can solve a system of linear equations with complex numbers in it. Here we have a system of linear equations with complex numbers. J is the square root of negative 1, which is sometimes called as I. X and Y are two unknowns. And like the real case, you can just take the coefficient matrix here and change this into AX equal to B type matrix equation. Now, if you want to solve this using the Rref method, you should put these two matrices into a single matrix like this, and then all you have to do is just plug this into your calculator and do the Rref if you have TI-89. Now, the trouble with TI-83 is that you cannot put it doesn't allow you to put complex numbers into matrices. So you have to do this very complicated way of solving the equation using real matrices. And at the end of the video, I hope you can manage it, or you might just decide to buy a TI-89. Okay, but let's see how it goes. Now, the key to changing a complex matrix into a corresponding real matrix, so you can just plug this into the calculator to solve, is to change a single complex number into a 2x2 matrix. How do you do that? Well, first think about this 3 plus j as 3 plus 1j. And put those two numbers, 3 and 1, as a column vector. So you have 3 and 1 up and down. And then you have to put another column right next to it. And the way you do it is you flip these two numbers. 3 and 1 gets flipped into 1, 3. And then you have to negate the top one. Okay, so you have to, and you have to do this for every one of these elements, even if the number is real. So what it does is it doubles the size of the matrix, both rows and columns. So this is a 2-row and 3-column matrix. Therefore, after this process, you will end up with a 4-row and 6-column matrix. So you will have a huge matrix. That's why this method is so complicated. Okay, let's move on. This is the first element. Now let's think about the second element. Even if it's real, we still need to change it to 2x2. To do that, you think of negative 2 as negative 2 plus 0j, and therefore you put negative 2 and 0, and then again you flip and negate the top. Here we also have 3 minus 4j. What do? You put 3 and negative 4, flip and negate the top. So if you negate a negative 4, you get positive 4. Alright, so let's say we did this for all the elements in here, then you end up with this big 4x6 matrix. This big matrix just to solve system of two linear equations. So if you have to solve a system of three linear equations, that means you will need 6x8 matrix, and so on. It's quite complicated, as I warned. Okay, so let's try to put this into your calculator. By the way, you should try to put this in a piece of paper before you put it into the matrix. That way, you won't make much mistakes, and also it's much faster to plug it into the calculator. All right. So how do you do this how do you put this into your calculator? You put matrix as before. You go to edit, enter, and then we want a 4x6 matrix, 4x6 matrix, and then you start plugging all these numbers in: 3, negative 1, negative 2, 0, 3, 4. Okay, 1. 3, 0, negative 2, negative 4, 3, negative 3, 0, 1, 2, -1.5, 0, -3, -2, 1.5, -1. Okay, finally we're done. So second quit. Now what do? We have to do the REF. So again, do the matrix math, and you go all the way down until you see the REF here. Here it is. Now enter, and then you're going to choose the matrix A, the one that we just picked. And now we're going to press enter. Now what do we get? Let's see what we get. Okay, so we get some strange matrix. Oh, see, here I have 2 and negative 1, and if my calculation was correct, this negative 1 has to be appearing here with a positive 1, and 2 should appear here as 2, because there should be the flip with the negation at the top. So this means actually I made a mistake. So let's go and change it. Matrix, edit. Let's see where I made the mistake. 3, -1, 1, 3, -3. Okay, 0, -2, 2, 1. 3, -4, -1.5. 4, 3. Okay, there it is. That should be -0.5. Okay, now let's go do the REF again. All the way down. Enter. And then matrix. Enter. Enter. Alright, so now much better. Okay, so we get some result of the REF. What is that? Let me write it over here. Okay, as you can see, this is the result of the REF, and the way you're going to read this is you look at the second to the last column, this column right here, always. Always go to the second to the last column, and then these are just values of x, y, and all these unknowns, where two pair of numbers correspond to one complex number. So for example, if you have 2 and negative 1 here, that means x is 2 minus j, or 2 minus 1j. And if you have 2 and 1.5 here, that means y is 2 plus 1.5j. Now, what I told you a little moment ago is that these numbers should correspond to taking these two numbers, flipping it, and negating on the top. That has to be true in all cases, so that's a good check. If your final REF form doesn't look that way, then you should go back and always change the matrix. Correct the matrix. Okay, so we have the solution here, but usually in engineering classes, they want the answers in the polar form. So let me tell you how to do the polar form. So instead of writing 2 plus 1.5i, I want to change this into a polar form. And what you do is, let's see, you put 2 plus 1.5. In TI83, the I is above the dot. So it doesn't show here on the screen, but if you do second and the decimal mark, then you get this letter I. And then what you do is you put press math twice to the right, so that's the complex number, and then way down there you have the polar. Enter. And now let's see what it does. It says 1 plus 1.5i, and I want to convert it to polar. And that's the result. It says 2.5 e to the power of 36.86 something And it doesn't show here, but at the end there should be an I. Yeah, here you see, you have an I, right? And basically what this is saying is that the angle, the phase shift is like 36.86 or 87, and the magnitude of the complex number is 2.5. So when you see this, the way you're going to write your answer is you put 2.5 with the angle 36.87 degrees. That's how you say it. Okay, thank you, and I hope you can make good use of this.